And now back to Bobby Likas Car Clinic and your host, Bobby Likas.
Okay, here's the drill. If you'd like to call in, 888-CAR-CLINIC is the number. Jan will take your call. And we're going to do something a little different for this first segment to surprise our guest. You know, that's right, Terry. Welcome, Terry Sebastian from Daytona, WNDB.
Awesome day. We're here at the 40th annual Turkey Run at Daytona International Speedway. It's also the 40th anniversary of American Graffiti. So with that, we've got Cindy Williams, Candy Clark, and Bo Hopkins out here signing autographs. But the true stars is the cars. They've got the cars from American Graffiti. I'm right here by the fan zone at Daytona International Speedway. Bobby, it doesn't look like anything like the fan zone. You remember when you were here.
Well, and folks, this is the gentleman that took me around the track, and we were talking at, I don't know, we were running 120, 30 miles an hour, and this fellow was just like, you know, it was asking me questions. I said, let me look at the wall here. It looks like the wall is coming at you pretty fast at 130 miles an hour. I understand that this show from Jennifer Labonte, who is the Director of Public Relations and Marketing for the Daytona Beach Car Shows, that this is the first time they've sold out of Car Corral spots in 5 years. It's a huge show, right, Terry?
It's a huge show. And to put it in perspective, the Car Corral is right next to Lake Lloyd. And you know how long Lake Lloyd is?
I do.
Well, the Car Corral is about 10 rows of cars the whole length of Lake Lloyd. And that means you can go buy a car here.
So there's actually is there an auction going on, or you just walk up to someone and say, what do you take for that car?
I'm walking here, but the Car Corral is where you sell your car.
Oh.
And so there is every kind of car you can imagine. Of course, there's pieces of car, too. They might be missing an engine. There might be just an engine. But if you want to buy a hot rod, or if you want to buy a classic car, you can buy the whole car here, or you can buy a piece by piece.
How cool is that? Terry Sebastian from WNDB. And, folks, we're going to do something a little different. If you'd like to talk with Terry, Tony, the director, can put you through to him on the air right now. If you call 888-227-2546. We'll conference you three-way, and you can ask him a question. In the meantime, that number is 888-227-2546. We're talking with Terry Sebastian live from Daytona Beach, a report. And Terry, I understand some 125,000 people are expected to attend this event.
I think they're going to break that number. From what I've seen, yesterday was a beautiful day, a little bit cool, but the numbers were overwhelming. It's just getting started today, and it's like a carnival atmosphere. The people watching is just half the fun of it. But then when you throw in, where I'm standing at right over here by the fan zone where the drivers park their RVs is the show cars. And I see a Corvette, split back Corvette sitting over here. Right next to it is a 56 Ford tow truck. And then right next to it is a Packard. It just looks like they're in mint condition. And all these cars, they're ready to hit the road. It's amazing the vehicles you see out here. But also, right in the middle of that, right here is Emery Riddle with their jet dragsters and Elaine Larson out here showing off her jet dragsters. So it's a carnival atmosphere. And then, hey, I started the day off right. Think about this. American Graffiti, what's better than a good old root beer float? That's how I started my day when I got here. Fresh made ice cream and a root beer float at Daytona International Speedway at the Turkey Run.
Okay, that's the official breakfast from now on of the Turkey Run. The official breakfast is root beer float. That sounds great to me.
Hey, Bobby, it's sensory overload. I've been working with the Turkey Run for 10 years, and this year just seems like there's a whole new level to it. The Turkey Run, what this is the Daytona Racing District, which collects the rent from Daytona International Speedway, and with that, they are allowed to have up to a year. They started several years ago, and the Turkey Run started as just a group of guys got together on Main Street, and then they needed a bigger place to go, and it moved to Ormond, and they needed a bigger place to go, so it came here to Daytona, but it's been going on for 40 years. And just amazing what they've done with this little car show where some guys got together 40 years ago to show off their classic cars and their hot rods.
And Terry, question, can you ride around? I understand that you can, and I know that you and I have ridden around the track together, but is that possible during this event?
for the spring car show, it is. I think the numbers are so overwhelming here for the turkey run at Thanksgiving, but for the spring turkey run, when you pay to put your car in the car show, you also can take a lap around Daytona International Speedway. So, and of course, there's going to be a nice photo op, and I'm sure some beautiful pictures of your classic car. Probably crossing the start-finish line at Daytona International Speedway.
And a quick question. What about those folks who are tuned in to WNDB right now that really haven't made up their mind as what they're going to do today or maybe tomorrow after church? Give us an overview of what they could see if they come out to. Is that the place for them to come out to the track today?
$15 gets you into the track. Parking is free. The Speedway is parking. You come onto the property. And then you get in here, and you can walk for days. If you were going to come here, you should have started Thursday, because you're never going to see everything next Sunday. It's impossible. And that's just it. It's sensory overload. When you start wanting to. But the other factor is the people. These people, this is their pride and joy, and they love showing them off. I think that's the fun of it. You can tell the hard work they put into it, how proud they are of their 55 Chevy. We even got the Volusia County Sheriff's Department has a 62 Volusia County Ford Fairlane all decked out just like a 1962 police car. And it's original with the Thunderbird motor in it and everything just like a 1962 police car is. So even the Volusia County Sheriff is still on their classic car.
And Terry, what about all the construction that's going on with the Daytona Uprising or the Daytona Rising?
Rising. I'm standing in the fan zone, and you can see right now, I'm looking out at one end of the grandstand, and the new rising of the new grandstands is coming up over the back of the grandstand down toward turn one and also down toward turn four. And what they're going to do is they're slowly putting these two sections, they're going to meet in the middle, and we're going to have a whole new grandstand by the time this is over with in 2016. And that's what's cool. This is a huge event right in the middle of construction zone.
Yeah, that's pretty cool. I would imagine that 2016 would be a whale of a year to make your reservations to go to the track. That's when they're going to roll out the complete new renovation, and that's when it's all going to be and come together.
Well, Daytona Rising is amazing what this speedway is doing. It's so great. Some of these seats are original seats from 1958 when they built the track. It's time to upgrade. They're not just going to upgrade. They're going to make this like a stadium. Like when you go to a football game and all the things you see when you walk into one of these nice stadiums, that's what you're going to have here. Only it's going to be 2016 technology. You're going to have all that internet access. You're going to have hotspots. You're going to have time screens. You're going to have more restrooms than they've ever had, more access and more comfortable access, escalators, ways to get in and out of here that's going to make it easier for you. And that's what it's all about at Daytona International Speedway. It's the fans. At Daytona Rising, it's about taking care of the fans.
We're talking with Terry Sebastian, WNDB 1150 AM in Daytona Beach. Terry, I have two rather straightforward questions. You'll hate me afterwards, but number one, what's your favorite pick of all of the vehicles that you've seen? Let me make it a little easier for you. Of all the cars, so I don't mean, wild machines and piggybacks and trailers and tractors, but of all the cars, what's your favorite? And second, Florida State or Alabama? Auburn. No, I'm not. Alabama's going to beat Auburn. Florida State or Alabama for the national championship?
I'm going to have to go with Florida State. I'm a Gator fan, but if you got to pull for any other school, at that level, I'll have to pull for the Seminoles. So Florida State, my brother was a Gator. I grew up pulling for Gators. The only time you pull for the Seminoles is when the Gators aren't playing. So I'm going to have to pull for the Seminoles.
Well, as Tony said, Tony, the producer, he's a Gator man. He says you got to get past Florida first.
Well, it's going to be great. Football. I just finished football last night locally. Last home game for Mainland, who's going to the semifinals in the state championship here in Florida, and we carried our last football game last night. Unless they win next week and go all the way to the Citrus Bowl, and we'll carry that in 2 weeks from the Citrus Bowl and state championship game. So local high school football is big here.
Good.
But there's some fans here that are pulling for the Seminoles. We're sorry for what the Gators did this year, but I'm sure they'll make it up.
I'm sure they will. Terry Sebastian. Terry Sebastian, WNDB. Terry, thank you so much for coming on and for sharing the information. And your favorite car, quickly, 5 seconds.
My favorite car is a Petty Blue 1970 Superbird. Beautiful car, ready to hit the racetrack.
Wow. Fantastic. Hey, thanks so much for the live report, and stay with them. Enjoy the day. And folks, if you're in the Daytona area, you got to get out to the racetrack and just take and participate and take a look at all those automobiles, all those specialty cars out there. Terry, again, thank you for joining us on Bobby Likas Car Clinic.
Bobby, don't forget the Spring Car Show, March 28th, 29th, and 30th. For all of your listeners out there nationwide, come to Daytona. It's sort of our way to end Speed Week and everything. It's the last thing that really happens here after Speed Week, Bike Week, Rolex, and all that. We had a car show to wrap it all up. What a way to go.
Yeah, it's a way to grow the community, and it's a way to grow the national presence. Terry, again.